morning students, welcome back to our next class. So in the last class we have discussed few problems on the probability. So today also we'll continue with the few more problems based on the probability. Now coming to the next question, 12th question. A box containing 6 white and 4 green balls. So in a box there are total 6 plus 4, 10 balls, which are 6 white and 4 green. So what is the criteria here? If 2 balls are drawn, so out of those 10 balls, we are selecting 2 balls are drawn at random. So those 2 balls are selected randomly. Find the probability that they are either white or green. So what is the probability we need to find? When 2 balls are picked randomly from a box containing total 10 balls, so those 2 balls should be either white or green balls. So here the condition is given, either white or green means whatever the 2 balls we have picked, those two should be either white or those two should be either green. They did not say those two balls are white and green. Here they are saying they are either white or green. So two balls should be white or two balls should be green. So if all condition is given, we have to use unit. If they are red and white and green. So there and means you have to use intersection. But in question or is given. So for doing the problems in the probability, first thing you need to observe the question and read the question carefully. What is given in the question, you need to understand the question properly, and according to that question only we need to solve our problem. Now the same criteria how we have done the previous class problems using the addition theorem, where also we will be using addition theorem only because we have the OR condition. So first write down the total outcomes, total number of outcomes. So how many balls are there? Out of those how many we are picking? Total 6 plus 10, 6 plus 4, 10 balls are there. So out of those 10 balls, how many balls we are picking randomly? 2 balls. So number of total outcomes is 10c2. Find out 10c2 value. 10 factorial by 10 minus 2 factorial is 8 factorial into 2 factorial. This can be written as 10 into 9 into 8 factorial divided by 8 factorial into 2. 8 factorial gets cancelled. 2 ones are 2 5. So 5 nines are 45. So there are total 45 outcomes for this experiment. So therefore, n is equals to 45. Now describe the two events. So let A. So first I am writing event A. So let A be the event of getting the 2 white balls. A be the event of getting we are taking into, so that is 4c2, 4 factorial, which can be written as 4 into 3 into 2 into 1 divided by 4 minus 2 factorial is 2 factorial into 2 factorial. What is 2 factorial value? 2 only. 2 into 2, it is 4. 4 and 4 gets cancelled. 3 2s are 6. So which implies n of b value is equals to 6. Now we got the all the number of values. Now we will find out the probabilities. So first P of A equals to n of A by n of S, which is equals to, what is n of A value? 15 by n of S value is 45. P of B is equals to n of B by n of S, which is equals to 6 by 45. So at the same time, we have to also find the intersection value. So what is A intersection B here? Here we are saying, whatever the two balls we are drawn, here those two balls are white balls. Here two balls are green balls. So is there any common thing in these two events? No. So that's why A intersection B is equals to null set. Here the condition is or. That's why event A is different, event B is different. So A intersection B value will be 0 because there are no common terms. So now according to addition theorem, P of A union B is equals to P of A plus P of B minus P of A intersection B. Substitute the values. P of A value is 15 by 45 plus P of B value is 6 by 45 minus P of A intersection B equals to 0. Since A intersection B value equals to null set, that is probability of null set will be 0. So 15 plus 6 is equals to 21 by 45. So therefore, the probability that two balls drawn at random are either white or green balls is equals to 21 by 45. So if you want to cancel, you can simplify it. That is, it goes in the 3 table, right? So 3 sevens are, 3 ones are, 3 fives are. So that is equals to 7 by 15. So therefore, P of A union B is equals to 7 by 15. So this is the required solution for this problem. So these are all the problems we have done till now, which are based on the addition theorem. Now we will find next problems will be based on the multiplication theorem and also the independence of attributes concept. Now coming to the next question, that is 13th question. Three students are selected at random from one after the other from a class consisting of 12 boys and 8 girls. So in the class there are 12 boys and 8 girls, that is total 20 students are there. Out of those 20 students, how many students are selected? 3 students are selected at random, one after the other. That means after selecting the first student, the second student is selected. Next, the third student. So they are not drawn at the time. One after the other, 3 students are selected from total 12 boys and 8 girls. So first is let event A. Let A be the event of selecting first girl. Of selecting the first girl. So here they are saying there should be all the three girls should be sorry all the three students should be girls. So first event is let A be the selecting a girl at the first time of selecting the first girl. That is for the first selection. You can simply write here first selection. Next event will be second selection. So second selection means B given A. So why we are writing B given A? They said one after the other. So after happening, that is after selecting the first girl only, we are going to select the second one. So that's why B given A be the event of selecting second girl. That is event of the second selection. Next is we have to select the third girl. The third girl means event C. Here we are going to select third girl after the first and second girls are selected. That is A intersection B. A intersection B has already happened means first and second girls are chosen. So third one has to be done. Be the event of third selection. So here B given A is the event of second selection after first. Here we need to specify here because we are writing conditional event. B given A is the event of second selection after the first selection is done. So similarly, C given A intersection B is the event of third selection after first and second are done. First and second are done. Now we need to find these probabilities. That is probability of A, probability of B given A, probability of C given A intersection B. Now first P of A. So what is P of A? We are going to select one girl from total students. So generally what is the formula? Favorable outcomes divided by total number of outcomes. Here what are the total number of outcomes? 12 plus 8, that is 20. So out of 20 I am selecting only one girl because event A means selecting one girl. So first you write down the total number of outcomes is 20C1. You are selecting 20C1. And girls, how many girls are there? 8 girls are there. So out of 8 girls, I am selecting one girl. That is 8C1. So these are the favorable outcomes. 8C1 divided by 20C1. What is 8C1? NC1 value will be always N itself. So that is equals to 8 by 20. Similarly, P of B given A. So B given A, the total outcomes will be how many now? Already one girl is selected. So remaining there are 7 girls. So out of those 7 girls I am selecting one. That is 7C1 divided by, there were total 20 students, from that one girl is already selected. So only left out how many? 19 students. So 19C1, which is equal intersection B value. Now, by using the multiplication theorem, so what is the value of the multiplication theorem of three events? A intersection B intersection C is equals to P of A into P of B given A into P of C given A intersection B. Substitute the values. P of A is 8 by 20 into 7 by 19 into 6 by 18. So find out the value. So cancel it. 2. These 2 goes in the 3 table. 3 2s are 3 6 are 18 and 2 4s are 2 10s are and again 2 1s are 2 3s are. So what are the left half terms? You can cancel this also. 2 2s are 2 5s are. You can directly cancel in 4 table. 4 2s are, 4 5s are. So 2 by 5 into 7 by 19 into 1 by 3. So 7 2s are 14 divided by 5 into 19 into 3. 5 3s are 15. 15 into 19, it is 285. So 14 divided by 285. So therefore, P of A intersection B intersection C equals to 14 by 285. So the probability that 2 students are to be girls is equals to 14 divided by 285. You can write the answer either in the fraction or you can also write in the decimal values. So, now we'll continue with the next question. Now the next question. Two aeroplanes hit a target in succession. So there are two aeroplanes. Aeroplanes suppose A, B are two aeroplanes. So those two aeroplanes hit the target. The target is set. That it reaches the target is in succession. Successful means one after the other. So the probabilities of each correctly hitting the target are. So aeroplane A, the probability that the first aeroplane hits the target and also the probability that second aeroplane hits the target, both are given. So respectively they are 0.3 and 0.2. So the probability that first aeroplane hits the target is 0.3. The probability that second aeroplane hits the target is 0.2. Now next, what is the condition here? The second will hit the target. The second one hit the target. If the first misses, so when does the second aeroplane hit the target? If first is missed, then only the second will hit the target. If first hits, there is no need for the second one. So find the probability that, so we need to find the probabilities. The first bit is the target is hit. So here they have specified just the target is hit. So target may be either hit by the aeroplane, the first aeroplane, and also it may be hit by the second aeroplane. So what is the condition here? Target is hit means it is either by aeroplane, first aeroplane or second aeroplane. So here we need to find the value of P of A union B. So next, what is the second bit? That both aeroplanes fail to hit the target. Both aeroplane fails means there is a complementary. So the probabilities we are considering for hitting the target, not complement. So what we have to find here? Both fail to hit the target. Both fail to hit means first one and the second one fails to hit the target. So we need to find probability of A complement intersection B complement. So here we are going to use the independence of events concept in this problem. So first write down the given two events. So let A be the event that first aeroplane hits the target. Let A be the event that first aeroplane hits target. And the second event, I'm denoting with B. Let B be the event that second aeroplane hits the target. Already these probabilities are given. So what are the condition? So probability that first aeroplane hits, what is the probability that second aeroplane hits? So that is P of A value is given as 0.3. Similarly, P of B value is given as, so here respectively two aeroplanes hits the target values probabilities are given as 0.3 and 0.2. Now, what is the first bit we are going to find? First bit is probability that of target is hit. So, target is hit means either it may be by the first aeroplane or the second aeroplane. So, probability of aeroplane 1 hits the target. P of aeroplane 1 hits target or aeroplane 2 hits the target. So how can you write this one? A or B, right? Two events are given. So A or B means this value you can write it as P of A, that is the first aeroplane hits the target, union second aeroplane hits the target. So what is the condition that second aeroplane hits the target? The condition is the second will hit the target if the first is misses. So first misses means first one is failed, that is A complement, and we are going for 0.14, 0.3 plus 0.14 is 0.44. So therefore, probability that target is hit is equals to 0.3 plus 0.14 is 0.44. So first bit is finished. Now we will do the second bit. Probabilities of different events. So in the next class, we'll continue with the next topic.